What's going on, everybody? Teddy Baldessar here, and in this video, we're going to be continuing our series looking at the best Japanese watches. This is part two, looking at watches between $400 and $1,000. Let's get into it. So I will just say it right up front. This was a very hard list to construct. A lot of great watches to mention in this range, particularly from Japan. But to start off our list, we have a true favorite of the community, the Seiko Cocktail Time. And we're gonna be looking at the references, the SRPB41, the 43, and the 46. These watches come with a price range of $320 to around $450. You can find that SRPB43 for even a little bit lower than that, but most of the watches here are going to fall between that range mentioned. Case size of 40.5 millimeters, case thickness 11.8 millimeters, powered by an automatic Seiko 4R35, water resistance of 50 meters, and has a Hardlex crystal. And these watches are just simply beautiful. They look way more expensive than what the price tag might indicate, and is a great option for those that might be looking for that next dress piece that is in a relatively affordable range. Now, when you think of watches over $400, I guarantee one of the brands that you do not think of is Casio, but Casio is actually the next brand that we're gonna be looking at. And the particular Casio watch we have here is the Casio Oceanus. This is also known as their S100 model and is a very overlooked piece, I feel. Price here, we're looking at $450 to $600. Case size of 41.5 millimeters. Case thickness of 10.5 millimeters. Powered by a Casio module 5235. Water resistance of 100 meters and has a sapphire crystal. This watch is solar powered. It has a 7-month power reserve. But I think the really two most notable things here is you have that solar automatic radio, you have that world time complication, and having a titanium case and bracelet. You're getting a lot of watch here, and simply this has me questioning, Casio might need to separate some of their higher end watches like this Oceanus, maybe their Edifice line, to really position themselves in a better light in the marketplace. Because I think a lot of people, when they see Casio, they think cheap digital watches, which isn't necessarily the truth all the time. So I have to admit, this watch probably could have went in the last video because it's right on the cusp of that range that I mentioned at the beginning of the video, but the watch here is the Orient Polaris GMT. This watch comes with a price range of $350 to around $425. We're looking at a case size here of 42 millimeters, case thickness of 11.98, so just under 12 millimeters, powered by an automatic Orient 40P51 movement, water resistance of 50 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. So the movement in here, of course, in-house, both with hand winding and hacking capabilities. And in our Facebook group, I saw a good amount of these watches, and I always see them quite frequently. So I wanted to mention this watch. I think it falls in a very good price range. And I was really on the fence, this watch or the Orient Star Seeker GMT. I just decided to go with this one just from the price standpoint. And another watch that probably could be mentioned here, but I wanted to kind of diversify things a little bit. Now for our next watch, we have Citizen and the Citizen Courageous. This is the reference BL125853L. And with this watch, you have a price range of $500 to $640. I've seen some go below that as well. We're looking at a case size of 43 millimeters, thickness 12.5 millimeters, powered by an EcoDrive E764 movement, water resistance of 300 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. But this watch here, coming with that perpetual calendar and being solar powered, is the definition of just set it and go. You're not gonna have to worry about this thing ever once you set it. And this is a very good option here if you're somebody that just wants convenience, wants to have a watch that's reliable and doesn't have to worry about setting it or resetting it in case you didn't wear it maybe in the last few days or so, especially considering you're getting a multi-month power reserve on this thing. Now for our next watch, it probably doesn't need any introduction. I've owned the watch, it's been seen everywhere, so many people talk about it all the time, it's been discontinued, and it does have a very polarizing status in the watch community, and that is the Seiko Alpinist. So the Seiko Alpinist, also known as the Sarb 017, comes with a price range of $450 to $550 nowadays. These have went up a pretty good amount in the last year or so. Case size, you might see 38 millimeters in a lot of places, but it's actually a 39 millimeter watch. It wears a little bit larger than that 38, which a lot of sites have it at. Case thickness, 12 millimeters, powered by an automatic Seiko 6R15 movement. That's a movement you're gonna be hearing a lot throughout the rest of this video. Water resistance of 200 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. But this watch should be mentioned. It was one of the most requested in the Facebook group when I asked the question, what watches should be mentioned in this video? And although I found it wasn't really for me and I think it has become a little bit overrated, I do see the love for this watch. I just think visually it is a little bit all over the place and I don't know how much versatility you'll get out of it. The specs don't really necessarily match the overall design and aesthetic where I don't think it can be utilized to its full potential. At least that's my opinion, but still, a good watch. And in the last video, I asked if the Seiko SKX was overrated. I'll ask the same question here. Seiko Alpinist, do you think it has become overrated? So there are a lot of great divers in this price range, and I think Japan knocks it out of the park when it comes to affordable diver watches, and I probably wouldn't look anywhere else if I was trying to get a diver. And in my last video, I looked at Orient, and I also looked at Seiko a good amount. So let's start there, look at those two brands. And the first watch here is the Seiko Sumo SBDC033. So this watch comes with a price range of $450 to $550, case size of 44 millimeters, case thickness 13.3 millimeters, movement we're looking at an automatic Seiko 6R15 movement, water resistance of 200 meters, and has a Hardlex crystal. This watch comes with that certified diver stamp, so you are going to have professional diver certification here, and for the money, I think is a very notable Seiko in this range. But the other watch here is from Orient, and I think probably is the, from a spec standpoint and getting a very reliable diver, probably the best you can find from Orient, and that is the Orient Triton. This watch comes with a price range of $370 to $460, case size of 43.4 millimeters, thickness we're looking at 13.6 millimeters, powered by an automatic Orient 40N5A. We're looking at a water resistance of 200 meters, and it has a sapphire crystal. So this is a JIS Class 1 diver, so you're getting that professional diver certification. It has that sapphire crystal with some AR coating. And overall, I think this is just a very good watch. It goes head-to-head with the Prospects line from, say, Seiko, and you know, might be a good choice if you're somebody that's looking for that certified diver type of watch from a very good brand. So now for our next two watches, I decided to pair them together because I feel they're always mentioned in the same breath whenever I see them mentioned. That is the Seiko Sarb 033 and the 035. So these watches come in with a price range of around $450 to $600, very similar to the Alpinist, have gone up in price quite a bit as of late. Case size, 38 millimeters. We're looking at a case thickness of 11.2 millimeters. Powered by an automatic Seiko 6R15 movement. Water resistance of 100 meters and has a sapphire crystal. So far we've seen a lot of notable fan favorite type of watches mentioned on this list so far. And that's probably without coincidence considering these watches are just such good value for money. I think Japanese watches in general just present that. And I think we're looking at maybe the epitome of that and probably the reason why these have become discontinued because you're just getting so much watch for the money. So I'd imagine once Seiko, they will probably reissue these in the future and probably at a higher price point. Now as a perfect segue from the Sarbs, I've been positioning this next series of watches that I'm gonna be mentioning here quite frequently as an alternative to the Sarb line. And I do think as the Sarb 033 and the 035 start going down in inventory, now that they're not being produced anymore, these are going to be watches that you're gonna wanna take a look at. And those are the Sarks 043, 045, and 047. So price range on these things are at $500 to $600 usually. We're looking at a case size of 39.5 millimeters for all of them. They are gonna wear a little bit larger with that 48 millimeter lug to lug height, but they're not gonna wear too large. I have a 6 1/4 inch wrist, and when I wear my Sarks 045, I think fits perfectly. Case thickness, we're looking at 11.3 millimeters, powered by an automatic Seiko 6R15 movement, water resistance of 100 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. So I'm actually wearing my Sarks 045, and I love this thing. It is very, very versatile. It has the ability to look very, you know, dressy with its very thin doffing hands. It has that cool blue panel style dial. The 043 has that white panel dial. 047 has more of a blue-green type dial. So you have a good amount of options here. Oh yeah, and also check out the Sarks 015. Very similar styling, sizing. Has a black panel dial that's a little bit different. Has the hollowed hands, which look pretty cool. And I did ask the question on my Instagram in a previous video if I should do a review on one of these things, and I got a lot of yeses. So I probably will do it, but a really interesting watch that you should take a look at. Now for our next watch, we look at a line that I think is so underappreciated, and that's Orient Star. We're gonna be looking at the Orient Star Elegant Classic. So this watch comes with a price range of $350 to $500. We're looking at a case size of 38.7 millimeters, thickness 12.9 millimeters, powered by an automatic Orient 40N52, water resistance of 50 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. So this watch features beautiful Breguet style hands, a power reserve indicator, which measures the 40 hour power reserve of the automatic movement with hand winding and hacking capabilities, and a textured guilloche dial. I see this watch being a step up from the Orient Monarch line, and I think a really good option if you're looking for something with a little bit more elegance and maybe a little bit dressier of some flair here. That's a little bit different than what you'll see with a lot of watches in this price range. All right, so we looked at some dress watches. Now we're gonna go back to diver's watches, then probably go back to dress watches, but let's go to diver's watches. And the next diver's watches we have here are some really awesome options. The Seiko SBDC 061 and 063. These watches are also known as Baby Marine Masters. They are Japanese domestic divers and some of my personal favorites of the entire Seiko diver lineup. We're looking at price ranges here of $700 to $900, case size of 44 millimeters, thickness of 13.1 millimeters, powered by an automatic Seiko 6R15 movement, water resistance of 200 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. So the 6-1 is a black dial version, and then the 6-3 is the blue dial version. Another thing to consider here are the American releases of the Seiko Prospects line, the SPB 077 and 079. These watches have become a little bit more difficult, all these watches have, to find as of late. So if you can find one, you're interested, these are some of the best divers that you can find in this price range. So when I am thinking of the last stop somebody can make before maybe jumping into Grand Seiko territory is this lineup of watches right here. And that is the Sarx 033, the 035, and the 055. So these watches come in with a price range of $700 to around $1,100. The high end here, so from like $900 and say like $50 to that top range of the price range here of $1,100, that is gonna be for the 055. And then from $700 to around that $950, that's where you're gonna find the Sarx 033 and the 035. I'll talk about the differences in a moment, but from a case size standpoint, we're looking at 40.8 millimeters, case thickness of 11 millimeters, powered by an automatic Seiko 6R15, water resistance of 100 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. So the Sarx 033 comes with that white dial, and then the Sarx 035 comes with a black dial. And they're essentially the equivalent for the Sarx line to the Sarv line. And then when we're looking at the Sarx 055, the differentiation comes in the case primarily. So we're looking at a titanium case for under $1,000 in some cases, which is fantastic. It looks very elegant with that silver snowflake dial, and really is the last step before jumping into Grand Seiko land with their Heritage line and Elegance line. Now next up, we have arguably one of my favorite lines, and one I think is never considered by so many people, probably because they don't even know it exists, and that is the Seiko Sard line. And the watches from this line that we're gonna be looking at are the 006, the 009, and the 007, but primarily the 006 and the 009, as those are my favorites. So a price here, we're looking at $900 to around $1,100, case size of 39.2 millimeters, case thickness of 13.2 millimeters, powered by an automatic Seiko 6R24 movement, water resistance of 100 meters, and has a sapphire crystal. This watch features a retrograde date and day display, which balances out incredibly well with the power reserve indicator on the dial. You also have the 007 option with its more playful numerals, but personally, I do, again, just prefer the 006 and the 009. And this is a watch you do need to consider, which I don't think many of you are. And now we finally made it to our last watch. It is the Orient Star World Time. And we're looking at two references here. We're looking at the SJC0002D0. That is the blue dial version. And then the SJC00001B0. And that comes with the black dial. So these watches come with a price range of around $1,000 to $1,500. Case size of 41.5 millimeters with a case thickness of 12.65 millimeters. Powered by an automatic Orient 40H60. Water resistance of 100 meters. And has a sapphire crystal. These watches do fall above $1,000 in typical scenarios, but I have just found them right around $1,000. I think it's at like $1,035 on Orient USA's website. And a world time around that price from a Japanese brand, pretty solid if you ask me. So guys, those are my choices for this video. If you guys did enjoy this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon. 75% of the people that watch my videos are not subscribed. What are you guys doing? I know you're watching. Subscribe to the channel, and because that would be a big help too, because this was definitely a lot of research and a lot of things to consider. Tough list to make. Also, don't be a watch enthusiast that does not consider watch straps when you're buying your watches. You want to get the most out of your watches. Head over to my website. We have some of the best watch straps in the industry for the money. I'd put them up against any other watch straps, and any purchase also supports the channel and the content that you're watching, and really allows this all to be possible. I decided to make the plunge, guys, and go full time at this, so that is a big help for me. And then finally, if you want to enter our watch giveaway, fill out the watch giveaway form. You only need to do it once. If you've done it once, you're good to go, but also be following me on Instagram to be eligible for our monthly giveaways. And guys, thank you so much for watching. Be well, and I will see you all very soon.